Fight number two. We've got a little three one and a half minute round fight. Two young guys here.
Yeah, time for the youngsters, the young guns, to give us some action. Got Liam Powell fighting out of the red corner. Luke White in the blue corner. And Liam Powell's gone straight to work.
They've both come out a million miles out here. This is the thing with these shorter fights. They can be absolutely full of action.
Yeah, some of these shorter round fights, especially with the youngsters, they're in front of a crowd like this. They want to impress. They can come out and they can turn into absolute barnstormers, these fights.
I think Red Corner's got a bit of trouble with his head guard there.
His head guard's risen up. Yeah. You're going to want to tighten the bottom of that up a little bit because it's going to keep moving otherwise. Not much to split the two of them. They're both in the middle of the ring, both fighting, both throwing their punches, both landing.
They can't both coming out at a furious pace here.
Can't imagine this is going to take long to catch fire again, Martin. Got White opting to poke that jab out and trying to keep Liam Powell at bay, but Liam Powell's trying to walk through and
he's relentlessly coming forward.
Easier, but he needs to start throwing on the way in as well. At the moment, he's just walking into range and catching that jab with his head guard at the moment, which is going to catch the eyes of the...
It's not where you want to catch it, no. Oh. It's a shame. He was just starting to get through there until the loose head guard let him down a bit there. Here we go.
Got White's corner. Powell's corner calling for him to stick to the basics. They're calling out 1-2. And what that means when you hear that from the corners is that they want him to just do the basic stuff, do the simple stuff. The jab, the right hand, just keep it nice and simple.
Nice straight shot through the middle.
I think that was a tough one to score. I think Powell at the beginning of the round there. I think Luke White, with his jab, probably nicked the last 30, 40 seconds of the round, which might have been what caught the judges' eyes. Yeah.
Here we go, round two.
Yeah, White's come straight back out and start poking that really. He's got a really nice sharp jab, hasn't he, for a youngster? He's got a...
Yes.
Pokes it in the face of his opponent and then moves off. That's really good work. I think this head guard isn't doing Liam Powell any favours. It's really riding up, which is going to be affecting his vision.
Yeah.
And that's definitely going to be having an effect on the way he performs. But you've got to deal with what's...
What you've got, yeah. Yeah, exactly. There's nothing worse than a loose head guard. It's moving again already, that head guard.
So it's been a while since you fought in a head guard, Martin, isn't it?
Yeah, luckily, it's one thing I could never stand, to be honest with you. It's one thing I hated.
So only for sparring nowadays?
Yeah.
He's really struggling with that head guard.
As soon as it's touched again, it's moved again.
It does, yeah. It's a shame to keep talking about it, but that is... I mean, it is moulding the fight, really, isn't it? He can't see what's coming at him.
No.
And come out with good work. That was a lovely little jab.
I mean, you cannot deny his spirit.
No,
he's
exactly,
coming forward relentlessly.
But even there, like, he's coming forward, he's got his gloves up, but because that head guard's in his vision, he can't see and react to the shots that are coming.
Yeah.
But he's still in there and he's still trying.
Yes, he is, yeah. We've got a good tear up going on here.
I think that round is slightly clearer in favour of White, in my opinion. I'd score that 10-9 in favour of White.
Yeah, he's a very good little mover and got a good jab. And obviously Powell's got that head guard again hindering him.
The referee calls the fighters to the middle of the ring for the third and final round in this fight. It's been a really exciting fight. It's been a shame about the head guard, but he's dealt with it as best as possible. Yes. We must say, let's not take nothing away from the quality of work that Luke White's been putting together. That jab has been absolutely fantastic.
It has indeed.
This is really good pressure from Powell. He knows that he's behind after that last round. He knows he is. So he's come out and he's trying to take the fight to Luke.
He put some good pressure on there, landing some good solid shots at the start. Powell's got on his bike a bit, trying to throw shots, but...
This is exactly what Powell needs to do. He needs to put the pressure on. He needs to let those shots go.
Yes.
This is a really good round for him so far.
Yeah, good jab there. Yes.
He's taken away the little bit of rhythm that Luke White had put together with that jab that he was pushing out.
Yes. That jab from Powell has broke his rhythm. And allowing him to then land other shots, his combinations.
Powell's taking a breather. I'm sure he's just waiting for another opportunity to launch another attack.
Yeah, certainly looks that way.
And again, we've mentioned it a couple of times, but Powell has not stopped coming forward, has he?
He has not. Absolutely 11 out of 10 for effort.
That was a really good shot there.
Really good shot
on the
counter. What a great fight that was.
David Denman. Let's give both of these boxers a massive round of applause before we announce the results. After three rounds of action, ladies and gentlemen, it's too close to call. It's a draw, ladies and gentlemen.